This tutorial shows how to conduct the two-sample t-test or independent sample t-test in R and interpret its results. The purpose is testing the means of two groups for differences. For example, I have a trained and an untrained group of people and I want to test for a difference in the average number of push-ups between those two groups. Let's quickly talk requirements. You obviously need two independent groups. You also need a dependent variable on an interval or ratio scale, an approximate normal distribution of the dependent variable within the respective groups, and finally, equal variances across the groups. Testing for normal distribution and equal variances is shown in the videos linked in the info cards to keep this video as short as possible. As a first step after importing data, I want to see the mean and standard deviation of the number of pushups for my two groups. I recommend the psych-package for that and its describeBy function. I can see that the mean of the trained group is a bit higher compared to the untrained group, 61 versus 52. The standard deviations are roughly the same with 9.82 and 9.87. You can also use box plots for visualizing the data. Now I want to test whether the means are significantly different from each other. For this, I use the t.test function and start off with the test variable, the repetitions. After that, I use the tilde, the small wave symbol, and then put the group variable behind it. Note that the default testing will be two-sided, meaning you test only for a difference. In case you proposed in advance that your first group has a greater mean than the second one, you can add the argument alternative equals greater. This works if you simply have numbers for groups. If you have names for groups, the alphabetical order is used. If you hypothesized a smaller mean for group 1, use alternative equals less. I can run this one line and get the results. If the p-value is below the predefined threshold, for example 0.05, the null hypothesis can be rejected. Reminder, the null hypothesis for the two-sample t-test assumes no difference of the mean between group 1 and 2. Or trained and untrained. In my case, I defined alpha as 0.05 and can therefore reject the null hypothesis because my p-value for a two-sided test is 0.035. I can conclude that the means 61 and 52 are obviously different from each other. If I tested one-sided for a larger mean of group 1 compared to group 2, I could certainly see that result as well. The p-value would be half in this scenario. After a significant two-sample t-test, the effect size should be calculated, which is shown in the following video.